really done a Netflix review in a while, so I figured I might as well do one and do The Kissing Booth. While I was gathering info on The Kissing Booth, I noticed that it's apparently based on a book that was released on a thing called Wattpad, which is kind of like a fan fiction-y, like pretty much anybody can post, you know, chapter by chapter, their own stories that they make, whether it be like fan fiction or just regular fiction or all that stuff. So I guess that's kind of interesting that they're doing, you know, doing adaptations of stuff from, you know, stuff like fan fiction, kind of like amateur stuff, and they're making like actual like Netflix films and Hulu films and all that stuff out of it. So I figured I'd give it a shot. You know, why not? Let's see what happens. Now, this kind of genre isn't really like my thing, but I figured I'd give it a chance anyway, just because the trailer was fine. I did notice that it's very fan fiction-y, which isn't shocking because that's kind of like what this was to begin with. I mean, they just throw everything at you exposition-wise. Like, you pretty much learn Joey King's backstory and the brother's backstory, all that. Within, like, the first 3 minutes of the film, you pretty much know every single detail about their lives. And it's like, there was no time to really develop any of that stuff. They just, like, this is everything that has happened in my life up until this movie has started. And she's, like, in high school. So, it's a lot of information just throw at somebody the right very beginning of the movie, but that was a little jarring. Plus, the story is pretty predictable and cliche, because it really is just boggled down to. It's about a girl who's best friends with a guy who's kind of dorky, but, I mean, they get along really well, and she kind of just has always had the hots for his, like, super hot, attractive, older brother, bad boy kind of style character. And, you know, things happen at a kissing booth. You know, she kisses him, and they kind of, like, fall in love, but they made ground rules that they're not allowed to date siblings and whatnot, so she kind of has to, like, sneak behind his back to actually, like, do things with him and, you know, shenanigans, I guess. It's very teen romance fanficky. Like I say, I keep saying that, but that's all I can think of. Like, that feels very fanficky. Like, it does play out beat by beat very predictably, because you know that eventually he's going to find out that, you know, they're best friends and she's messing around with his older brother behind his back. And, you know, obviously, things don't go very well, so, of course, conflict. Of course, it seems like I'm ragging on the movie completely, but there actually is some entertainment there. I mean, I like Joey King as an actress. I mean, even though I'm not, like, the biggest fan of the roles that she takes in a lot of things, but she does her best with the material she's given to make it believable, because I don't think other actress really could have made this part as less cringy, because some of the dialogue they give her is a little, like, off-putting. And even the two main leads, the brother and the older brother, they're not bad with what they're given either. I mean, they play the parts that they're given pretty well. I mean, some of, you know, it is very stereotypical, but I mean, could have been worse, right? Plus, Molly Ringwald's in this movie for like a hot, like, 3 minutes. I mean, it makes no difference really to the plot if I mention that Molly Ringwald's in it. She's just one of their mothers, but it's just like cool to see Molly Ringwald in something that's like current, not like The Breakfast Club or all those films that she's known for from, like, 30 years ago. To delve back into some negatives, though, the movie did start to lose me probably about, like, the midway mark, just because it's so melodramatic and so over the top with some of the stuff that happens. I mean, yeah, I mean, high school, like, everything feels like the end of the world in high school, but they just really overreact to a lot of the things in this movie. Like, it's not very believable. Plus, this movie feels like it should have been, like, 20, 30 minutes shorter. Because they really lost me, because it felt like they really just tacked on a lot of stuff. I never read the book. I'm guessing the book is similar. But I really feel like they could have just, like, skipped probably a good chunk of the last act of the film, and it would have made no difference to the actual plot. Because it really just drags for that whole portion of the film, and I was kind of just hoping that it would end, even though I knew it wasn't going to end. It's like an hour and 45 minutes, and it should have been like an hour, or an hour, a little over an hour, just because it wasn't interesting after a while. I definitely realize that this film isn't meant for my target demographic, because I'm not really into the whole teen romances thing, but I still figured I'd give it a shot, and it's not that great for me, just personally, like I said, but there are people that are into teen romances and romances in general and all that, so maybe someone else will enjoy it a lot more than I did and get a lot more entertainment out of it. I mean, it's on Netflix, so it's not like you're really losing much by going and watching it whenever you know, on your phone, or, you know, when you're just bored one day. I mean, if you got an hour and a half, hour and 45 minutes to watch, and you're into teen comedies, I guess give it a shot at least. But I mean, I don't know. I mean, I'm not gonna rewatch it. So I don't know if I can really recommend it either, just because it's not my thing, and I thought it was like okay in parts, but not overall. But yeah, those are my quick thoughts about The Kissing Booth. I mean, it's on Netflix now, so if you've, you know, want to go see it, it's on Netflix right now. But if you do see it, or if you plan on seeing it, leave a comment with your thoughts down below, what you thought about it, or, you know, if you plan on watching it. Also, you know, feel free to leave a like. I appreciate it. Also, hit the subscribe button to keep up to date with all my movie reviews, unboxings, and everything else that I do. But until the next time, I'll see you guys later.